Welcome back to Gunny Morning Quarterback. Today we're going to talk about Minuteman versus Militiaman. So, what's the difference between the two? To start, in modern times, every man and woman is the militia. Now, there are able-bodied and unable-bodied alike, and I would say that in today's day and age, even the unable can serve in some way as a part of the militia, more of the support side, whereas the able-bodied are more of the frontline cannon fodder that history has always shown us to be the case. So if you're on the middle, or if you want nothing to do with this and just don't really care and just want it to be over, you are the worst kind of person. Pick a side. I mean, at this point, it's gotten too hot for fence sitters. Only the cowards stay perched. A militiaman has potential, but may not necessarily be mentally or physically prepared. And so they're also likely blind to more national and global issues. They may not be current on all that. And not just any topic that the news just happens to throw up, mainstream corporate news. Those are not the real issues. Those are the issues that are, those are the issues that they want you to be aware of, for certain things like funding and money and politics, all that kind of stuff. But the Minuteman kind of goes a step further than that and asks the deeper questions of why things are actually happening the way they are, and what is the end result going to be if that whatever is going on is allowed to finish as planned. A lot of collectors of firearms, and certainly if there's dust collecting on those firearms, that is a sign of militia. Minuteman will collect to some extent, but all their tools are for a purpose. They each has its own purpose, and there's also some that they plan to hand out to family members, loved ones, when the time comes. But again, they're not just collectors, and they're not pro-gun. There's a huge difference between pro-gun and pro-2A, which I go over in depth in my book. A modern semi-auto fighting rifle is absolutely mandatory, no matter if you fall in the militia side of things or the Minuteman side of things. It's mandatory. You've got to have one. Now's your chance to get one. Not having a modern fighting rifle is neglecting your duty. And when I say duty, I do not mean duty to the government. The government used to be the people. Now they lord over the people and rule over the people, and there are two different classes of citizens. And so that's a massive problem. They use a looming threat of violence to ensure that the people stay in line. And that is probably what was behind a lot of this Malinowski hit job that the ATF did, was to kind of reignite that fear that a lot of people have. Some people are afraid, some are prepared, but it was to reignite that fear. That's why it's been so publicized. That's why it was done the way it was done. That threat is just always supposed to be hovering and looming over you. Ruby Ridge and Waco have kind of faded from memory, sadly, and so they needed a refresher to keep that mindset going. A militiaman may or may not CCW carry everywhere they go, but a modern Minuteman certainly will. A militiaman may bring a rifle caliber firearm with them when they travel out of state or out of town, but a Minuteman knows that you kind of always have to have that as your go-to whenever you are out of your house, because when you're in your house, that's assumed you have that. But when you leave your house, and especially for extended periods of time, rifle calibers really can't be beaten for if stuff were to happen while you're not home. And in case you need to get home, if things have gone really bad. Militiamen may not have gotten that far in their 2A journey yet, so not gigging them for that. Well, actually, I kind of am gigging them for that. You need to get moving. You need to get with the times, even if it's a smaller platform, you need a rifle caliber with you, I dare say, at all times. The Minuteman understands that we're on borrowed time right now. That's all these good court decisions have been. They've been great. There's been some really good decisions lately that the government is frankly not obeying, but the key to this is that it's just buying time for you and your family to get ready. That's the only benefit that can really come of this in the end. It's not gonna end well. The Supreme Court is not gonna hold the government's feet to the fire over this. They have no teeth, and that is sort of why the people were set up to always have that right to keep and bear arms, to be the teeth against any of the branches that get out of line, which, by the way, at this time, it seems that we really have three of the three branches out of line, aside from the Bruin decision. And even that has some tainting to it, some taint. Aside from that, all three branches have absolutely lost their mind. One of the two, militia or Minuteman, talks about a line in the sand, and the other realizes that the line has long been crossed, and at this point it's just kind of being rubbed in our face. If you haven't figured it out, the Minuteman is the one that already knows that that point is already come and gone, and it's just, again, like I said, a matter of time to when things will get very, very heated in Minecraft. The Militiaman knows that he needs to prepare, whereas the Minuteman knows that he has not prepared enough. You can never prepare enough. There's people that do really well with preparation, but really you can't prepare for whatever's coming our way. Nobody knows exactly how anything is going to go down. It's just going to go down, and you just have to be ready for almost any circumstance that may come our way. And going on with that theme, the Militiaman is waiting for a written invitation, which is never going to come. The Minuteman knows that it's not going to look like what you'd expect when it starts. In fact, as we said a minute ago, it's already started. There's not a hard line of when these things start. Even with things like Civil War, when that happened, there was not a clear line. A lot of people say it was at Fort Sumter, and that's not true. The actual war had already begun a while before that point in time. The Militiaman may shoot once or twice or even quarterly in a year, whereas the Minuteman is dry fire practicing multiple times a week and hopefully can get out maybe bi-weekly. Weekly would be ideal to go shooting, but the big thing is that they take advantage of the dry fire principle and get better in the comfort of their own home, and really stay sharpened and warmed up in the comfort of their own home, because you do need to go to the range. You do need to actually shoot at targets. You can't really get around that, but you can make a lot of improvements, and that's the advantage of dry fire. Finally, and one of the biggest steps, is that both the Militiaman and the Minuteman go on to Amazon and order Rules for Thee. It is my book that I wrote, and it will help you become a better Minuteman. It'll help you become a better Militiaman, just a modern protector. But again, we're always headed towards that modern protector Minuteman role. And everything we do with training and preparation, we are preparing for things that we don't know exactly how things are going to go down. And a parting thought to keep you in a good mood for the rest of the day. Murders by the ATF are added to the gun death statistic and rate, and used against you, the citizen, to justify the further taking of your Second Amendment rights. Ironic, huh?
Is that 16 inches? Is that SBR?
Yeah, man. Legal? All legal here.
That's legal.
Legal as one can
this
be.
16 inches.
Yeah, about.
Maybe a little bit longer. Calibrated, but if I pulled out this pecker and I marked 8 places on that, I'm getting 16.
And you're gonna measure it? Are you saying your pecker's 2 inches long?
You got more than that? You got more than that? That's the average, right?
Good. Considered micro penis?
Hope that cheered your day up. Thanks.